Channel 3 Early Warning Weather with meteorologist Mark Dixon.
All right, we are at the tail end of all this wet weather. Conditions will be improving as we head through the next couple of hours, and that will happen from northwest to southeast across Connecticut. And we've got early warning pinpoint Doppler zoomed into the greater Hartford area and points south. This is a loop over the last 30 minutes showing the progression of the rain. You can see some of those yellows, oranges, and reds, for instance, moving out of Glastonbury, heading over the Connecticut River, passing just to the east of Cromwell. Meanwhile, there are some showers around Berlin that are maybe going to clip the golf course there at the TPC River Highlands. But once this moves through basically the very end of it, and we're going to see some partial clearing getting underway. So that's where the heaviest of the rain currently is ongoing in the state throughout southeastern Connecticut. Some light, steadier rain there along the 95 corridor from Old Lyme through New London and over to the Rhode Island border. So again, on the statewide perspective, things certainly improving. The rain has come to an end throughout much of Litchfield County, and conditions again will be getting better as the afternoon moves forward in time. So temperatures here in the noon hour close to 70 along the 95 corridor, mid and upper 60. Across inland Connecticut. We do have a north-northwesterly breeze out there at around 5 to 15 miles an hour, indicating that the front, of course, has moved through and that wind direction will filter some drier air into the state. So notice, for instance, in northwest Connecticut, dew point values now in the upper 50s. Elsewhere, still in the low and mid-60s, these numbers will continue to come down. So the comfort level of the air will certainly be much better by later today and certainly through the weekend. So where I can view from Hartford, you can see as we look toward the east, we've got the back edge of that rain that is reducing visibility a bit. Our view from New Haven showing the International Festival of Arts and Ideas. So conditions as well improving there as the afternoon moves forward. And this afternoon, forecasting highs to reach, say, the mid and upper 70s inland, a little bit cooler in the northwest hills. And with that wind off the land as opposed to off the water, coastal communities could get close to, say, the 80 degree mark this afternoon. So we will see at least some breaks in the clouds, some partial clearing as all this wet weather finally pivots out and away from southern New England. So the front again is offshore. We've got that northwesterly breeze. So dew point values will be coming down. Remember yesterday when I showed you this map, we had yellows indicating those dew point values into the 70s. Now they're in the 60s heading into the 50s. So a welcome change for sure. And the timing could not be better for the weekend. Here is future cast with regard to dew point values. Starting off at the noon hour today, watching how those numbers will come down into the upper 40s and low 50s later on this evening and tonight. Tomorrow, basically upper 40s and low 50s throughout much of the day. So by late June and by now early summer standards, we're looking great with regard to the comfort index for our Saturday, and we can expect the same for Sunday. So future cast showing the rain again tapering off, some partial clearing this afternoon, then we go mainly clear tonight. Tomorrow forecasting ample sunshine from the morning right on through the course of the afternoon. A few fair weather clouds may develop. Then for Sunday, as we take you through Sunday afternoon, looking quite nice as well. The absence of gray indicating the clear skies that we're forecasting. So in our 7-day forecast tomorrow, again, comfortably warm, low 80s, several degrees warmer inland on Sunday. So looking good for round 3 and round 4 of tournament play at the Travelers Championship. Morning lows will be in the 50s. So if you're perhaps getting in a long run or going to go out to early in the day to do some gardening, the weather certainly will cooperate. And if you're heading to area beaches, looking good as well for Saturday and Sunday, highs 80 or better. Monday, we start off dry, but also hot, upper 80s inland. And then on Tuesday, we'll see an increasing humidity and an increased chance to rain and possibly some thunderstorms, and then the heat remains around for Wednesday and Thursday of next week. Perhaps close to 90 inland, 80s for the coastline.